Authentication or authorization, what are the differences, which one to choose, and how to implement them in a Spring Boot application? I've already talked about authentication in some other videos. I've created a playlist where I've implemented multiple ways a request can be authenticated: JWT, cookie, or session. The authentication is the action that validates that a user who makes a request is allowed to talk with my application. But not all the parts of my application are accessible to anybody authenticated. I may have different people who are trying to access my application: admins, regular users, editors, B2B systems, and more. Not everybody has the same privileges. The regular users must not be able to change some configuration parameters, or the editors may not be authorized to update the prices of external services. Here comes the authorization. Even if a user is authenticated, it may not be able to access everywhere. It's like entering a secure building. I may be able to enter with an authorization card, but only some floors are accessible with it. With Sprint Security, I can define some access roles and assign those access roles to the users. They will define the actions each user is authorized to perform. I already have configured the application with the annotation enabled web security. But with the authorities, I need a more fine-tuned security. Let's adapt this. This annotation says that the security will be defined at the method level. I've indicated the prePostEnabled to true, because this is the solution that I will use. I have two other possibilities: securedEnabled and JSR250Enabled. SecuredEnabled allows me to use the annotation secured, but this comes from older versions of Sprint Security. JSR250 allows me to use the annotations roles allowed, which belongs to Java X. The three solutions work very similar, but I've chosen prePostEnabled, which belongs to newer versions of Sprint Security, because I can use some SPL expressions. Let's now use the annotations. Within the pre-authorized annotation, I can use SPL expressions and some building expressions too. The permit all means that all the requests are allowed to this endpoint, even without any authenticated user. This case requires at least that the user is authenticated to request this endpoint. I've used the annotation in the definition of endpoints, but I could have used them in the definition of the methods in the service layer. Let's see some other examples. This time, I use the building expression hasRole with the name of the role. This means that to request those endpoints, the user must not only be authenticated, but I must also have the indicated role to be authorized to request this endpoint. For the last endpoints, I've used a different built-in expression, which accepts multiple roles, but I could have used an SPL expression. Another point, all the roles must start by the role prefix. Let's now enrich the user details entity with the roles, with the authorities. The UserDTO object contains the list of the roles associated with the given user. I must get them and map them into a granted authority object. From now, the user details in the Sprint Security session will contain the authorities for the current session. So, for each request, for each method annotated with annotation pre-authorized, Sprint Security will compare the indicated roles with the roles of the user object. Until now, I've used the pre-authorized annotation. But I also have the post-authorized annotation. This way, the check done by Sprint Security is done after the method execution. This has absolutely no difference with the pre-authorized annotation, which checks before entering in the method. The database transactions are managed the same way. When exiting the method, the database transactions are committed. Nevertheless, if I have some HTTP communication with external services, they will be done even if the user isn't authorized. So why choosing the post-authorized annotation? With the post-authorized annotation, I can make some more checks with the return value. I check if the body of the returned object has a size lower than 10. The returned object is a response entity, and the body of the response entity is the list of images. I check if the application returns less than 10 images. I can make some more checks with the return value. I can use the SPL expressions as I want. Let's recap what I've done. I've used the annotation enable global method security. I've enabled the pre and post enabled solution. I've added the pre-authorized annotation at the methods I want to protect. I've used some built-in methods as permit all or is authenticated. I've used the hasRole method with the accepted role for the method. I've enriched the user details of the Spring Security session with the authorities of the authenticated user. I've used the post-authorized method when I want to also perform some checks against the result of the method. That's all for this video. Don't forget to click on thumbs up if you liked it, and see you in another of my videos. Bye!